You're never too far, never too far from us. You're always with us, said you'd never leave. Emmanuel, God with us.
Alright, karibu mpenzi mtazamaji.
Tunawapeleka moja kwa moja mpaka pale Bridge TV.
Pale Teens TV, tukualetea habari moto kama pasi ya makaa.
Na tusome.
Leo. Greetings, ladies and gentlemen.
Hi, guys.
It's us. Dio,
again.
Back to our English services. Welcome.
Yeah.
And I know today is Sunday, but it's not just any regular Sunday. Mm-hmm. It's Easter.
Easter Sunday.
Easter,
yeah.
Sunday.
Yeah.
And I know it doesn't feel like it.
Doesn't really.
Unajua umezoanga Friday, you're off, your parents come home, Saturday, Sunday, you're waiting for Monday, yeah. But now you've been home for so long.
For so long.
Mekamata, it doesn't feel like it.
Yeah.
But it doesn't take away from the importance of this holiday.
Mm-hmm.
What was Easter to you, Kiom Dogoba?
First of all, we used to celebrate Jesus.
Hey.
Yes.
Hey, well done.
We never used to celebrate the Easter bunny or Easter eggs. We used to eat eggs, but never used to celebrate the Easter bunny. So my Easter kitambo, Easter yangu ilikuwa tu about Jesus, about going to church,
yeah,
and acting. You know, nilikuwa napata
hiyo
role ya Jesus. Ilikuwa poa. You know, and hey, ilikuwa nini yangu. How's your?
Okay, it's interesting. You were Jesus in your place. Christmas, I was always Herod. And then when it came to Easter, I was always like a soldier who was crucifying Jesus. Sijui. But actually, that's the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Easter bunny tuliona kwa TV when you bought our TV when I was in class 4. Nabado, like colored eggs didn't make sense. For us, it was Friday, mko church. Sunday, mko church. Monday, mko home. Lakini kuna tuka feeling ka, hey, Yesu amefufuka. Hey, that's the form.
Yeah.
Then afterwards I came to discover the Easter bunny. But you know, Easter bunny and Father Christmas never arrived in my village. But yeah, it's Easter.
Mm-hmm.
And Easter actually is what Hezrone has just said. It's all about Jesus.
Yeah.
All about what specifically about Jesus?
The fact that he came to die for our sins, you know, and he did not come to die for our sins. Me, I like to say that he came to die for my sin. You know, it's that personal for me. It's that personal that he came to die for my sins. Like when he was dangling on that cross, he was actually thinking about me.
Dangling?
Yeah, dangling one.
Hey! Man, just not hanging on that cross. So, I think it's the same for me. That, you know what, Jesus came to die for my sin.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, for the longest time, it was always for our sin.
Sins, yeah.
Because we are all sinners.
Yes,
not
salvation
just
is
for all of us. But I think it came to that point where you realized Jesus died and did not only die, but today on Sunday, he did what?
He rose.
He rose again.
Yeah.
Not the flower, but he rose again. I had to. It was so easy.
Forgive him. Forgive him.
But he rose again from the dead and conquered death.
Yeah.
And because he is risen, then I am forgiven.
Yeah.
I'm forgiven.
Given.
Yes.
Forgiven. And he died so that I could live, so that we could live.
True.
Yeah, that's amazing.
And actually, I think it is the ultimate expression of love.
Love, yeah, true.
That he died.
Yeah.
And today we'll talk about a story. We'll go into the Bible and talk about a simple story that we've all heard. The story of the prodigal son.
Yeah.
From the book of Luke. If you have your Bibles, if you don't have your Bibles, please run for your Bibles. We'll wait. Luke.
<can't>
Yes. If you don't have your Bibles, please pause, go, and then come back. We will wait as you pause. So, from the book of Luke chapter 15. Luke chapter 15 from verse 11 to verse 32. Please read this on your own. We will read bits and pieces.
Yeah.
We'll touch on a bit.
Yeah.
So let me read from verse 11 all the way to verse 15. Actually, to verse 16. Then Hezrone will lead. Hezrone will read. Will read.
As Hezrone, I read.
As you lead. You will read from verse 18. 18 all the way to verse 20, 22, 23 thereabouts. Mm. So let us read. Jesus continued, There was a man who had two sons. The younger one said to his father, Father, give me my share of the estate. So he divided his property between them. Not long after that, the younger son got together all he had, set off for a distant country, and there squandered his wealth in wild living. After he had spent everything, there was a severe famine in that whole land, in that whole country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to a citizen of that country, who sent him to his fields to feed pigs. He longed to fill his stomach with the pods that the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. Hezron, from verse 18.
Verse 18 says, I will rise and go to my father and will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you, and I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants. And he arose and came to his father. But when he was still a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and he kissed him. And the son said to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in your sight, and I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. But the father said to his servants, bring out the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and sandals on his feet.
Actually, just read paka, at 23.
And bring the fatted cow.
Not 24.
And bring the fatted calf here and kill it, and let us eat and make merry. For this my son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found. And they began to make merry.
Yeah. So I think the prodigal of the parable of the prodigal son, I think I just love how it illustrates salvation, mm-hmm. how it illustrates the love of God. That, you know what? We are all like the prodigal son. Mm. We looked at God and were like, no. Mm-hmm. May I want to do my own things. Yeah. I'm on
Onagi. Yeah, equally. But sometimes you feel like, hey, maybe salvation is too boring, but now, hey. Rules. We think salvation is all about rules. It's not all about rules. And sometimes God gives us these rules, not because he doesn't want us to have fun, but because if akituachilia, then tutapotea. You know, but we feel like, no, this is not something we want to do. And we
let him go. Laughing enough, ka point in aturarukia.
Yeah.
Kananuka kunuka.
Yeah.
And as this guy, and as the son went, got to a point where he was feeding pigs. Mm. From the son of a man who had a large estate to being a msa kuchunga nguru. Oi.
Yeah.
Unyo kuna kuchunga ngombe.
Mazi.
Kuchunga mbuzi.
Nguru inakula kila kitu.
Nguru
inakula kila kitu.
Alafu, ikafuka point, eti anatamadi kula food ya nguru.
Yeah.
How bad is that?
Eh.
Mazi, heri, unajua kuna kula nyasi, afu kuna kula chakula nguru.
Yeah.
Eh, heri uchemisha
nyasi. Heri ukarange nyasi.
Heri ukarange nyasi. Yeah. So he got to that point of saying, you know what? I feel like eating, and he came to his senses, and I think this is where we'll settle in.
Yeah.
He made up his mind to go back to his father
as a servant. Uh-huh. As a servant, yeah.
Why do you think he wanted to go back as a servant?
Because he felt unworthy, you know. Mm-hmm. After I think it was yesterday we were doing our Bible study.
Devotion,
we were saying it's interesting how when we drift away from God, and then when something bad happens, we blame God.
Yeah, you know, yeah.
And we start saying, we said it's interesting how people are not blaming other gods. They're just blaming our God for everything that is happening. And so he felt unworthy. And he said, I know if I go back and tell my father I'm willing to be a servant, then maybe he will take me back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because for him, actually, that's the thing. He felt he needed to earn.
Yeah.
Just going, he didn't feel like he was worthy to be a son anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But kuwa tu servant was enough for him.
Yeah.
And you get, and there's that feeling even for us with God.
Mm.
Like, we all know that God has offered his forgiveness, that God sent his son to die for us.
Mm-hmm.
But we usually feel like we need to earn it.
Yeah, yeah.
We need to work
for it.
And Romans 5:8 says that God shows his love for us in this way, that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
Yeah.
He didn't wait for you to come and be like, ufike mali. He didn't say, fika apa, alafu ni kukufie. He was like, wherever you are in your life, I will die for you.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the offer that he gave unto us.
Yeah.
That Yes.
It also reminds me of the shepherd who leaves the 99 to go after the one.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes when I, every time I think about that story, actually to me, it doesn't make sense. You know, it never used to make sense then.
Yeah.
And until that one is you. Until you are in that place where, Maze, you need that grace.
Yeah.
You know, you need that salvation. You need that grace. Mm-hmm. Until that one is you, until the shepherd comes for you, Maze, it will not make sense. True. It will not make sense at all.
True. Yeah. And today we just want to speak to you. Mm-hmm. Yes, you watching us in the camera. Unai tutazama kwenye
runinga,
ama laptop, ama rununu. Rununu. You don't have to earn God's forgiveness.
Mm-hmm.
I know when the father went and kissed this guy, what the Bible tells us is, he said, like when he was, before the father came, yes, the father ran to him. Mm. When the father was hugging him and kissing him, he was like, no, me, I've sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called
your son. Yeah.
We've gotten to that point of feeling we are far too gone that, wacha tu, I'm not worthy to be forgiven.
Mm.
But as the prodigal son's father came to him and hugged him, and kissed him. And even after he was saying that, this guy was just, the father ignored what he said and just said, no, leteni ile ring, leteni nguo.
Yeah.
This son of mine is back. He didn't say this servant.
Mm-hmm.
He said, this son of mine.
Mm.
And it is you, this child of God. No matter how lost you think you are, no matter how wicked and wretched and wretched you think you are, God says that while you were still a sinner, he died for you.
Yeah.
And he has offered this salvation as a gift to you. And over this period that we remember, Christ's death and resurrection for you.
For you.
Yeah. And for me and for Hezra and for all of us, actually the whole world.
Mm-hmm.
All I invite you is take this gift.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need to earn it.
Mm-hmm.
He has welcomed you to have it for free.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And reminds me, like all of us grew up in an African setup, right?
Yeah.
And imagine coming back from school, you've been expelled. And you come back and you're like, hey, my dad is going to kill me. And your dad hugs you instead. And he says, I know what happened, but I still love you. Mimi kwanza niko,
maybe
niko,
no.
Is this a trap?
No, this is something.
And then I hug you. So, I think that's how God is, you know.
Yeah.
And sometimes vilomesema tu, si ufeel kama ama kama kuna venye to forgive, you know.
Yeah.
Because he's so loving.
Mm.
Bako like, ay, no,
it. Because
then we are used to human beings treating us differently.
Exactly.
You know? Like the way human beings love us is different from the way God loves us.
Yeah.
So when we go to God, his love is different.
Yes.
Jusisi tumezoea kupendwa na binadamu, so tukienda kwa Mungu atupatie a different kind of love, like. Okay.
No. There is something fishy about it.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
But the truth is, his love is offered in that way.
Mm-hmm.
So don't treat the love of God like the love of man.
Yeah.
God's love is offered unconditionally.
Mm-hmm.
You just come.
Yeah.
He will hug you, kiss you, say the son who was lost is now alive.
Mm.
So you're welcome
mm-hmm.
to the kingdom, to his love,
yeah.
and to accept the free gift of love that is offered to you.
Mm-hmm.
So karibu.
Mm. Asante. Karibu pia.
Asante pia.
Mm. Na tunawapenda.
Tunawapenda
sana.
Mungu anawapenda
zaidi.
By like times a million.
Mm.
And always remember, you're not too lost that God can save you.
Yeah. You're not too far from grace.
You're not too far from grace.
Yeah.
Grace. No matter how far,
yeah.
he is still waiting for you with open arms.
Yeah.
So kwa hayo machache, kwa mapana na marefu, see you. Same place.
Same time.
Different clothes. Tutaonana.
Yes. And subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Yes.
Yes. And tell your friends.
Emmanuel.